Najee Garvin, D'Angelo Epps, Mario Haskett, and the big man down low, Dejor Dickens, for the Pirates and for the Spartans, Joe. They're starting five.
For the Spartans tonight, we have Kadarius Smith, Bryson Monzone, Jordan Ganey, Dalvin White, the reigning freshman of the week. And then we have, rounding it out, Josh Aldrich.
And again, your Sunbelt Rentals starting lineups here in Hampton. The Pirates strike. We'll have the first attempt as Dickens floater in the lane. No good. And the Spartans look to answer. Spartans in the all black, and it looks to be silver trim. Shot up and no good for Smith. Had Dejor Dickens right there to greet him, Joe. That's a tough task for anybody.
Yeah, absolutely. And, Matt, what I'm going to be looking for tonight is both teams to take care of the ball and capitalize on their possessions. We see Garvin getting down low. He's currently the leading scorer for these Hampton Pirates. But both teams are pretty turnover prone. Hampton averaging just 13 at turnovers per game, and USC Upstate at 14 a game. So turnovers is the battle that I'm going to be watching for tonight.
And those are your Ingles keys to the game. So Pirates with the missed shot. The officials say it was last touch by the Pirates as it went out of bounds. And a reminder, this Big South broadcast is brought to you in part by Hercules Tires, right on our strength. Visit HerculesTires.com. Ingles, low prices, love the savings. Sunbelt Rentals, we have equipment for that. And First Citizens Bank, forever first. And Joe, both teams right now just can't get anything going offensively as we take a look here at head coach Edward Buck Jonah Jr.
Yeah, Coach Buck is, you know, he's coming off this last win, but he wants to find some sort of consistency among his Pirates. And right now, you know, on the defensive end, they play with a high motor, a lot of energy. But as we see just now, they have a few breakdowns every now and again. So
yeah. That was Dalvin White, who is the first to crack the scoreboard for either team. Epps, three, top of the key, no good. Long rebound comes to Ganey, as you mentioned earlier, the reigning freshman of the week. His pull-up jumper from the free throw line is good. And just like that, back-to-back field goals for the Spartans put them on top 4-0 here at the Convocation Center.
Yeah, and Matt, I'm looking for the Pirates to get the ball into their playmakers. They have Dejor, as we see another turnover for the Pirates, but they need to get the ball into his hands. But the real playmaker for the Pirates is Garvin. He's going to have to be more aggressive down in that post if the Pirates look to put any points on the board anytime soon.
Yeah, you mentioned turnover is going to be crucial here. So far, Pirates have more than they would like with just 3 minutes here gone by. Shot no good. Pirates look to answer. Dean in the lane, trying to find an avenue to get the ball to Dejor. Comes back to Haskett. He'll take the contested three. Shot is good.
Knocks it down, and they're going to need a lot of that next man up, as they say, Matt.
Mario Haskett getting on the board early. That's definitely something his team likes to see.
As we take a look at Coach Dave Dickerson of USC Upstate, he likes what he's seeing out of his team thus far. He's just trying to make sure that they continue this same energy as the game moves on.
Epps in transition, goes to the basket. They're going to get him with an offensive foul. You like the idea of getting in the lane, but got to be under control.
Yeah, I like the physicality of this Pirates team. It's just one of those things where the call didn't go his way this time. You know, the defender got his body set, and yeah, there goes the offensive foul.
Right now, the Spartans shooting 2 of 6 from the floor for 33.3%. Pirates 1 of 5, and we're going to have a whistle, and they're going to call a foul. It was definitely a foul, but it was very late.
Very late foul. That's going to be Deuce's first.
Yeah, they waited for the shot to land out of bounds before they called the foul, but it will send White to the free throw line. White on this year from the free throw shooting 87%. Coming into today, he was 26 of 30.
And we see Deuce over here talking to the ref, trying to get some clarification on how that was a foul, or not how it was a foul, but why was it so late?
Both free throws are good. It's a 3-point advantage here for USC Upstate. Upstate. dribble drive. Garvin gets in the lane, and he's got contact on the shot.
And that's how he's going to get himself involved in this game, Matt. Being physical, taking the ball down. There was a little bit of an acting sequence there, you know, with the hands flailing in the air, but it got the ref's attention, and he was able to draw the foul.
The personal is charged to Jordan Ganey, his first. Team's first. So at the line for Hampton, Najee Garvin, the grad student. This year, shooting 75% from the free throw line. Coming into the night, Joe, 73-97. Garvin.
Yeah. He and Deuce Dean, the South Carolina products on this Hampton Pirates team. It's the South Carolina connection, as I like to call it. Both the top two scorers on this team. So, you know, they're going to be looking to lead their squad.
Yep. Garvin splits the free throws. Lead is 2 for the Spartans.
That's great defense by Haskett.
Good cut on the back door.
Just
Monzon.
Sleepy. Just a sleepy giant that time was Dejor Dickens. Didn't see his defender get behind him.
And he got caught peeking in the cookie jar, was watching the ball and let his man cut back door. The lead now 4 for the Spartans. Pirates look to answer. They go to Dean. Double comes. Pass intended for Garvin, deflected out of bounds, and it'll stay with Hampton. That will take us to our media timeout. You're watching Big South Basketball on ESPN Plus. We'll be back.
Power isn't born. It's built over.
Of the Big South, and for over 65 years has been providing tires with unbeatable quality at an unmatched value. Whatever the vehicle and whatever the terrain, Hercules Tires invites you to ride on our strength. For a retailer near you, visit HerculesTires.com. As we resume action here, Garvin up in the paint, getting the shot to fall and cutting that Spartan lead to 2. 15 minutes left in the first half of this contest. Right now, the Spartans just running their offense. Down to the paint. Smith up with the left hand, kissed it off the glass, and is good. So the Spartans are currently firing on all cylinders. Garvin thought about the 3. Takes it in the paint again. Up, and Dejor Dickens with the put-back slam. My, making a statement here in the first half. Dalvin White gets the ball to the corner. Monzon back to White. White looking to drive. Takes it among the trees, swing pass to the corner. No good, and rebound is grabbed by Deuce Dean. Pushing the pace back the other way and wisely slows it down. Skips over to Haskett. Haskett to Dejor, who almost lost it back out to Dean with the wide open 3. No good. Dickens almost grabbed the rebound, unable to corral it. White back the other way. Skip pass all the way to Monzon, who is fouled. And he will head to the line for the old-fashioned three-point play.
You know, Deuce Dean wants that open 3 back. The foul will be charged to Mateus. We take another look at the fast break here, Joe.
Yeah, and I mean, he did exactly what he's supposed to do. Monzon saw a wide open lane and said, hey, if you're going to give me some free points, I'm going to take them.
Mateus first, team's third. So now at the free throw line for the Spartans is Monzon on the year, an 80% free throw shooter coming into tonight, 32 of 40. And I don't know if there looks like there must be some blood on the floor, so the Hampton Trading Staff will come clean tweeting that out during this official timeout. And while we got a break, Joe, a reminder, Big South basketball fans, six exciting days in March. We'll see us go from 24 men's and women's teams at the start to two champions at the finish, all in one venue. It's the 2022 Hercules Tires Big South Basketball Championships at Charlotte's Bojangles Coliseum. Tickets and event information can be found now at BigSouthSports.com/CLTChamps. Make plans to come support your team in Charlotte March 1st through the 6th at the Big South Men's and Women's Basketball Championships.
I am trying my best to be down there, if not in a working capacity, as a spectator for some great Big South basketball. On zone to the line for his free throw opportunity, up and good. So he ups his average on the year.
There you go. Monzone with the old-fashioned three-point play gives the Spartans a five-point advantage. Godwin on the floor, replacing Bethea.
And with Godwin on the floor, USC Upstate is going to have to watch him. He is instant offense off of the bench.
What a pass from Haskett. See the ball movement. Spartans go to the zone, the penetration in the dish, and good touch around the basket by Garvin.
Yeah, that was beautiful ball movement by the Pirates on that possession.
20 seconds on the shot clock. Comes to Ganey at the top. Dribble drive. Pull up jumper and in motion knocks it down under heavy, heavy contest. Oh, Godwin. Pump fake. Got the defender in the air. His jumper way off the mark. And to the floor goes Garvin. He's fouled.
Yeah, that's going to be a foul on Monzone. Take a look here. Garvin has just been doing work. He has been a force in the paint.
Looks like they charged that to 35.
Oh, did they did?
Yeah, they wow. Put that on someone else. Jumper there, no good. Rebound to the Spartans.
And Godwin is the Pirates' best free throw shooter. Wow.
Pump fake, jumper, no good. And we got a whistle going the other way. Looks to be on Monzone, this one. So you were a play early.
Yeah, just one play early.
That's his first. So both teams now with three fouls apiece.
And I like the fight down in the paint for rebounds by the Pirates. Looking to find the open man. Garvin thought about the three, decided to drive, and just loses the ball off of his leg the other way.
Another turnover. That's the third one for Hampton. None yet committed by the Spartans. So far, those three turnovers have only resulted in 2 points for the Spartans.
Pirates need to count themselves as lucky. Pirates like the Spartans like to capitalize off of turnovers.
Ganey in the lane. Strong move. Could not finish. Godwin. 12 minutes remaining here in the half.
I'm glad Godwin slowed that down. He recognized that he didn't have the numbers, and instead of forcing it, he slowed it down, got it back to the playmaker.
And Garvin, right at the time, as you call it, the playmaker making a play. He doesn't take a lot of those.
He doesn't. That's not his game. I don't want him to do that. But on that possession, I don't mind it. And I'm sure Coach Buck doesn't either.
Ganey comes away, can't finish the layup, but the offensive putback is good for the Spartans. And they go back up by four. As we are under 11 and a half to go here in the half. Spartans showing man now. Godwin comes off the screen. Garvin, Haskett, little two-man game here with 7 seconds showing on the shot clock. Fadeaway jumper, Garvin, high arcing shot, no good. Rebound to the Spartans.
Spartans pushing the pace here.
Floater in the lane, got the roll wow. off the rim. And the lead now to six.
Brazil, man, that floater I didn't think was going to make it to the rim, but it did.
Just enough touch. Largest lead of the game now here for the Spartans at six. Air ball from Haskett.
That's what I don't want to see from the Pirates is them taking a bunch into three-point opportunities that they don't need to take.
Which then result in transition opportunities, and that looks to be the second foul on Epps, his second. That takes us to the immediate timeout. You're watching Big South Men's Basketball on ESPN+. We'll be back. Welcome back here, Big South Men's Basketball on ESPN+. Matt White, Joe Walters, and Dejor Dickens with the putbacks flush for the Pirates early on. Garvin following it up with a three from the outside, Joe. So even with that, strong play, Pirates trailing here at home by six.
Yeah, Pirates are they're starting to get it going. What's killing them right now are the turnovers. Right now, they have three turnovers to Spartan zero turnovers. So, you know, effectively that is 6 points that would have this thing knotted up.
Subs come in for both teams. Pinky Wiley and Ray Bethea on the floor here for the Pirates. Bethea in the lane.
And rejected, but they are not even able to get his shot off. Brazil to the corner, back out to Brazil up the top.
He'll take
takes the long three, no good.
It'll be Deuce Dean looking over the defense, getting in the lane, elbow jumper short. And right now it's back and forth here, a lot of missed shots here from the perimeter.
Yeah, both teams trying to capitalize on fast break opportunities, and it's the shots just have not been falling. I would much rather see them get into their half court sets, which is where they both have seemed to flourish.
They'll say last touch by Hampton.
And you see Dalvin White coming back into the game for Brazil.
Good minutes from Brazil off the bench. .41 remaining here in the half. Spartans throw it deep, and Marquise Godwin with an interception, one-on-one, Euro to the basket,
oh,
left the layup
man.
Short. Bethea comes away with the steal.
And you love it when your teammate cleans up your mess. But Godwin just muffed on a wide open layup, and I know he wants that one back. I'm pretty sure he'll make up for it later in this game.
Entry pass down low to Aldrich. He has trouble holding on to it. Now going to try and back down Bethea.
White, no good on his three-point opportunity. Here comes Deuce Dean and the Pirates.
9 minutes to go. Dean all the way down the lane and one.
The change of pace. Deuce Dean put the afterburners on and said, I will take it all the way. And he drives with the left-hand layup and heads to the line, picks up the and one.
Brings the Pirates to within two. I could not hear who the foul was charged to. Dean will go to the free throw line. This season, Dean, 70% from the charity stripe. In and out, no good.
If I'm Coach Buck Joyner, I'm telling Deuce, hey, keep that same energy throughout the game. I need to see you do that more often.
Lead remains at two. Spartans move the ball. Inside out to the left side. 13 seconds on the shot clock. Nice move along the baseline. Contact, no call. Skip pass, Pinky. Entry pass down low, but Bethea will tie the game with the lay-in. Great extra pass there from Pinky Wiley to Ray Bethea.
Beautiful execution. And we see the Pirates here at the other end trying to take advantage of a slow get back on defense, able to create some contact under the basket. That'll be a second foul on Deuce Dean.
Basket will head to the table to check in at the free throw line, Monzone. He's 1-for-1 from the free throw line. Strong free throw shooter for the Spartans. His first one is good.
And that stretch of this game. Both of them very, very, very good three-point shooters. So if they drop one and drop two, then we might see a storm start for the Spartans.
Monzon's number six scorer in the conference, coming in, as you said before, with averaging just under 15 a game.
Going to need to see the Pirates match that scoring.
Dickens, it wasn't pretty.
Wasn't pretty. As a big man, I never want to see my big man take the ball down that low and have to bring it back up. But I understand you need to gather power, and he was able to muscle it for two.
The back and forth seesaw game continues. Again, all square at 21. Step back jumper, baseline up, and Monzon is warming up.
That was just pretty basketball right there. Pretty one-on-one basketball.
Wiley runs, calls out the set for the Pirates. Godwin uses the screen. Wiley goes to Dickens. Pull-up jumper, good.
Nice.
You saw Dickens that time just use his God-given height and just soared above the defender for the easy jumper.
Absolutely. I want to see him use his height more often.
What a use of the glass there for the Spartans. That was white. I don't know how he knew exactly where to kiss that off the glass.
It was early for Valentine's Day. He said, just a little kiss.
Got it over the wingspan of Dickens. Spartans on top by two. 13 seconds as we hit the 7-minute mark here in the half. Haskett's going to have to figure out what to do with it. Skip pass. Bethea catching, shooting, shot, no good. Spartans secure the rebound.
I don't want to see these Pirates start to try and get into a three-point shooting contest with each other. I want them to just take advantage of what is being given to them and do what has worked for them.
Smooth jumper, no good. That was good low. Unable to knock it down. Godwin nearly turns it over, and he does. It's coming back, and there's going to be an offensive foul.
That was a blatant offensive foul. Goodlow did not have to do that. He was trying to create some sort of contact, but he did not have to do that. That just wasn't smart.
And that will take us to the media timeout. Spartans are on top. Back here on ESPN Plus, Goodlow made a good defensive play, got the steal here, Joe, and then just overthunk it, I guess, and tried to get a foul called and ended up getting a foul called, except it was against him.
Against him. I mean, just a brain fart, a bad foul by Goodlow. I mean, I don't know what he was thinking.
Yeah, nothing's guaranteed, but that was a pretty surefire, easy layup he had, or at least an attempt. At worst, he was going to get fouled on the shot.
Absolutely. That was a freshman mistake made by a junior. So,
kickball there on the pass from Wiley, trying to slip it into Luke Theron, who just checked in. And while we got this break, a reminder, Mountain Dew is charged for anything that may happen on game day. So grab yourself an ice-cold Mountain Dew. Cheer your team on and enjoy the game. We know our fans are the best fans. Do the do. Garvin back in for Hampton. Haskett gives it to him. He's going to take another three, Joe, and he knocks it down.
Garvin is doing the do. He hurts you. Garvin is heating up as we speak. We normally don't see the big man take many threes, but tonight he's knocked down two of them.
Pinky comes away with the steal. Pirates have numbers here momentarily, but he'll slow it down.
Bethea was hoping for an alley-oop.
Pirates with their first lead of the ball game, lead here by one. Haskett fouled as he tried to split two defenders.
The foul's going to be on White, his first, team second of the evening. Team six of the evening, excuse me.
Next one, we'll put the Pirates in the 1-1. So Wiley set to inbound, throws it deep to Garvin. Garvin right now with 9 points to lead the way for the Pirates. Wiley shot blocked on the drive. Spartans will push.
Here comes White.
Wiley comes away with the steal.
Luke Therian trying to get the ball out.
Pinky throws it up. Garvin, good read by the defense.
Garvin called for the alley, but ends up getting it into the lane to Therian, and he maneuvers for 2 points.
Yeah, good touch around the rim from the freshman out of Vancouver, British Columbia. His parents know are avid watchers. Under five to go. Dribble drive all the way to the cup. Layup up, no good.
Great defense by the freshman.
Aldridge had a good look there, couldn't finish. Garvin contact and will be an offensive foul.
And Garvin thought he had a little more space than he did. He was going to try to put somebody on a poster tonight.
Take another look at it here, but they good defense there by, I believe that was Monzone, able to get to the spot.
Absolutely it was. Absolutely it was.
So the Pirates with their largest lead here at three will fall back on defense. Garvin will take a seat as Epps will return to the floor.
I like Epps' play too. When he gets involved in the game, he brings a physicality that the Pirates need on the defensive end. So we'll look to see how he'll impact the game as we move to toward the end of this first half.
The two forwards, your leading scorer here in this game. Garvin, we mentioned, with nine. Monzone also with nine. Make that 12.
Wow. At corner three, he was just wide open. Nobody was by him.
Tie ball game as we're at the 4.5 minute mark here in the half. Wiley splits two defenders. Finds Haskett, his high school teammate.
Haskett with a long three. My gosh.
It is an air ball out of bounds, and it will be Spartans ball here as Deuce Dean will return to the lineup replacing Wiley.
And if I'm Haskett, that's my second air ball of the evening. I'm going to definitely try to step in closer to the rim so that I can start at least seeing something get to the rim and maybe drop for me.
Dean right now back on the floor. He's got to be careful. Joe, he's playing with two personals.
Yeah, he doesn't need to pick up that third in the first half.
Goodlow in the lane again. Runs into Haskett. They will call the blocking foul, and that will be the 17th foul on the Pirates. That, I believe, is just the first on Rio.
So Spartans are going to be headed to the line. Right now in the evening, they are a perfect 5 of 5, so taking advantage of all of their free points.
Good low so far tonight is the has the lowest percentage from the free throw line. He's coming into the night shooting 68% from the free throw line.
Maybe he'll knock these down to keep them perfect on the evening. What do you think?
And he does. And to your point, coming into tonight's game, Upstate is second in the conference with their overall free throw shooting percentage at 72.3%, just 5/10 of a point behind Longwood, who is 72.8.
And Goodlow knocks down those two to keep the Spartans perfect from the charity stripe this evening and take a 2-point lead with 3:50 left in the first half.
Rio drops it off. Epps drops it in easily.
Easy 2 points for Epps. Trying to lock his defender down.
Monzo up, under, nowhere to go. Good defense from Bethea. Finds White. Three. Goodlow off the mark. Aldridge with the offensive board. Second shot, no good. Still loose. Luke Therrien will secure the rebound.
That's what you Dean. Like to see from your big man. Deuce Dean all the way down the other end.
Nearly another 3-point opportunity for him. Strong take to the basket. And that strong take will take us to the media timeout. We're all locked up at 30. You're watching Big South Basketball on ESPN. And that's with 3 minutes left in the first half. All these games, of course, can be found here on ESPN Plus.
Yeah, Longwood, man, I tell you, after seeing them play, they are going to be a formidable opponent when we head on down to Charlotte for the Big South Conference tournament, man. They are balling crazy this year.
That's right. Hercules Tires, men's and women's basketball, or Big South men's and women's basketball championships coming your way March 1st to the 6th in the Queen City. As we now reach under 3 minutes, the Pirates go back on top by two with the free throws from Dean. 6 seconds, Aldridge backing down, handoff. White this time couldn't get the angle. And DeJore Dickens put that about three rows into the stands.
Wow, he just had nowhere to go after he dropped it off. Man, Aldridge dropped it off to White, and White said, I can do it. I can get it over this seven-footer.
They try to throw it off the back of the defenders, a la Jason Kidd, but the ball took a Pirate bounce, and with only 2 seconds on the shot clock, it is a shot clock violation.
Good defense by the Pirates. Great defense by the Pirates.
Yeah. Pirates, who started off slow offensively, now shooting 46% from the floor. Spartans, a shade under 40% at 37.9. Deuce Dean
with a stop and pop on the baseline.
Up to four.
I think this might arguably be one of the best halves I've seen out of Dean in a while.
We're nearing the two-minute mark. Aldridge, he'll pull for three off the mark. Garvin to Dean. Dean's had success creating off the dribble. He's in the lane. Pull-up jumper. Good.
He's heating up, people. The next bucket is going to be a heat check, and if he knocks it down, well, we know what happened.
He's
in NBA Jam.
White will look to penetrate. Pump fakes. Drops it off. Ball's loose. Garvin on the floor. He's able to secure it. And they will give the Pirates a timeout. Great individual effort there by Najee Garvin.
Yeah, we see here on the
That was the replay. Shot clock violation.
That was, yeah.
Again, Monzon tried to pull the Jason Kidd, but credit Garvin able to get a hand on it. And with only 2 seconds, that works, but you need more than 2 seconds on the shot clock because the clock starts the minute it hits the defender.
Absolutely. And I heard Najee when he came over, he said, that was a smart play. That was a smart play.
So we are in a timeout here, 1:37 remaining in the half. The Pirates with their largest lead of the ball game here now at six.
Matt, right now, I think the Pirates are finally settling into the game. You look at this huddle, you see laughter, you see smiles. They're not coming out here and putting pressure on themselves saying, we need to execute. They're just coming out and playing.
And reminder, we will be bringing you our first Citizens Bank first half stats before we get underway in the second half, just 93 seconds and counting away from halftime. See what Coach Joyner and his Pirates have drawn up here, wanting to take the momentum into the second half. Godwin's three is no good. Rebound to the Spartans, and here comes Ganey. Opportunity to cut into the lead. Monzon, three, no good. Garvin was looking for an illegal screen call, didn't get it. And the Pirates with another opportunity here to tack on to what's a six-point advantage, Joe.
And they are in no rush right now. They are, comfortably going into the half with a six-point lead, make that an eight-point lead.
Post to post.
So, they don't want to make any silly mistakes going into the half that can cut into this lead that they've built for themselves.
Both teams with 17 fouls, so both teams only shooting 1-1 if there is another foul here in this half. We've got the illegal screen.
Yeah. But the defender, he got way too open. I was trying to figure out how did he get that open, and we saw.
If you keep on track at home, that's the second on Monzon, so I would think you might want to take him out for this last 35.8. You don't want to risk him. And there he goes. You don't want to risk him picking up a third one here in what's effectively garbage time.
Yeah. Good coaching by Coach Dickerson.
Got to protect your star players. Of course, he wants to stay out there, but you don't want to risk it.
Yeah, no. It's not worth it. Not worth it when you got 20 seconds left in the first half and a whole nother half of basketball to play.
It's about a 5 or 6 second differential between the game and shot clock. Pirates will work the offense here. Dean doubled, dribbles out of it, all the way down the lane, up and under. He got his own rebound, and I believe he was fouled.
Deuce D. Dean playing with that motor I've been talking about. He's using the high quality oil today. That'll be the Spartans' ninth foul. So Dean will head to the line.
Didn't I believe they said it was on Goodlow?
Take a look here. Dean tried to get his own rebound and put it back and just unable to as he was swarmed by Spartan defenders. His first shot is going to be up and good.
Makes it a 9-point ball game, and that foul was on Goodlow, so that's his second. So, again, that's why you take Monzone out, because that very easily could have been
on Monzone. Yeah.
It very easily could have been him picking up his third.
Yeah.
7.6 seconds left in the half. An opportunity here to make it a double-digit lead as Deuce Dean with one more. Shot is up and good.
Nothing but net. Nothing but the bottom of the net.
And Coach Joyner doing the same thing, puts Haskett back on the floor, pulls out Dean, who was already playing with two, and picking up full court here. You don't want to give the Spartans anything here in these last 7.6 seconds. They drop it off. Swing. Gainey three. Contested shot.
Ooh.
Hey, Najee Garvin was right there, but right the there, freshman yes. of the week, Gainey, makes it a 7-point advantage for Hampton
great
as we
defense.
Go to the half.
Yeah, that was great defense by the Pirates. Just couldn't close out on that. And, you know, that'll take us into the halftime break. Pirates up 7 right now. Come back for second half action. Stay right here. It's Big South Basketball on ESPN Plus.
Back here on ESPN Plus, second half action about to get underway. And take a quick look at our First Citizens Bank first half stats that really jump out. And Joe, right now, Pirates with 18 points in the paint, 11 points off of Spartan turnovers, and what I really like, 11 assists on in that first half alone.
Yeah, Pirates doing a great job of moving the ball and taking advantage of their possessions.
And then for the Spartans, 7 of 7 from the free throw line and out-rebounding Hampton by a slight margin at 20-18. So your First Citizens Bank first half stats, a very well-played first half for both teams. And it was that run sparked by Deuce Dean that pushed the Pirates out to as many as 10 before we settled at 7 here.
Absolutely, and that's what I want to see more of from Deuce Dean in this second half as we see the quick foul by USC Upstate on Epps. That foul is going to be on Smith. That'll be his first of the evening, team first of the second half.
Yeah, Epps will head to the free throw line. On the season, Epps, a 72% free throw shooter at 18 of 25.
I want to see USC Upstate get back into the tempo that they were playing with early in this game when they were building what I believe was a 6-point lead. They kind of fell off in the energy department toward the end of the first half.
You're
but,
right.
I want to see them get back into form here in the beginning of the second half.
You're right. Largest lead of the game for the Spartans came 19-13, leading by 6. It really had the Pirates, I don't want to say on their heels, but they definitely were pushing the tempo as Epp splits the free throws for the Pirates, puts them back up top by 8.
But we saw USC Upstate, they were creating turnovers by the Pirates, which led to that lead. Oh, and Epps fouls the 3-point shooter for the very rare 4-point play opportunity.
Yeah, that was Gainey. Give him the 3. Epps, I believe that's his third.
As I stated earlier in the broadcast, if you were listening, Gainey is a heck of a three-point shooter on the season. He's shooting just over 50%, 52% if we want to be exact. So,
and the four-point play cuts the Pirate lead, which was just at 8.5. Tough young man out of Tucson, Arizona.
The West Coast produces some really good basketball products.
Yeah, product of the valley, as they say. Garvin, elbow, got the Aldrich in the air, goes, drew the contact. And that's more of what we saw in the first half from Najee Garvin.
Garvin just powering his way down in the paint against Aldrich. Aldrich, the 6'8 senior, 224 pounds, and Garvin, 6'8 and 220, so two large forces combining, and one just meets the floor because of the laws of physics.
Garvin's free throw up and good. Physics. You are something else.
Oh, man.
Second free throw is good.
Garvin capitalizes on both of his opportunities from the line.
Leading score in the game, Monzon with 12. Right behind him, Gainey with 11. Goodloe's three way off the mark. And leading for the Pirates, Garvin with 11. Deuce Dean with 10. And Dejor Dickens with a quiet 8 right behind him.
You know, I've seen a lot of air balls tonight. I want to attribute it to the fog outside. Maybe it's a little foggy in here.
Some of the fog has
it's clouding their visibility.
low visibility tonight in Hampton Roads. Dejor uses his size and uses the touch.
I like that. I would have liked to have seen him make that decision a little faster than he did. However, still same outcome.
White pull-up jumper, no good. Long rebound to the Bethea. Haskett skip past Dean, corner three, no good. Rebound to the Spartans.
One thing I'm not hearing from either team is a lot of communication on the floor right now. You pretty much want to hear a lot of conversation telling each other, hey, this is who I'm picking up, this is who you need to pick up, but I don't hear any of that from either team, which has led to the frantic back and forth that we've seen in the last few possessions here.
Foul charge to, I believe, Garvin. My zone back to the free throw line. It's good.
Keeping the Spartans perfect on the evening from the charity stripe. As I say that, watch he'll miss this one. Nope, he proves me wrong. 10 of 10 from the charity line tonight for the Spartans.
45-39 our score. So far, Upstate has outscored Hampton 6-5 as Ray Bethea shot up, no good. Rebound to Goodloe. Spartans are going to push. Goodloe all the way to the cup, and no one there to stop him. All gas, no brakes for Goodloe.
Beautiful dribble drive by Goodloe on that.
Spartans showing 2-3 zone. Minutes gone by here in the second half. Deuce Dean in traffic. Garvin thought about the three, goes to the floater, and it's good.
And I like that take by Garvin. He thought about that three-point opportunity and wisely said, maybe I'm at my quota for today. Let me go ahead and take this on into the paint.
To your point, though, now the defenders have to respect it. He made two early.
Absolutely.
So now he's playing with house money.
Yeah.
Shot no good for Upstate. Deuce Dean down the lane, blocking foul as the layup just falls off the rim. It's going to be on Aldridge, his second, third team foul.
You see him cradle the ball like a running back running through the lane there, just unable to convert on that opportunity, but he did draw the foul, and knock down his shots at the line.
Free throw is good.
Houston, 5 of 6 on the evening for the charity stripe.
Take a quick look at our Sun Belt Reynolds out of town scoreboard. Radford leads 51-40 over Charleston Southern. Longwood, 11-point advantage over UNC Asheville. Gardner-Webb and High Point knotted up at 42. And Campbell leads Presbyterian by 8, 37-29.
Deuce Dean knocks down that second free throw. So that'll give him 85% from the line so far this evening.
White tried to split the defender, deflected off the foot, I believe, of Dickens, and will remain with the Spartans. Turnover. Spartans couldn't handle the inbound. Dean goes behind the back in trouble and is able to find Haskett.
That was a lucky find by Deuce.
Haskett nearly lost it, but they will pick it up. His shot up, no good. And we're going to have a whistle.
Is that a jump ball or a foul?
I believe they're going to call a foul.
No, they call a foul. Yeah. Make sure you get social with the Big South. Join the always growing network of Big South fans on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and more. You can also follow the conference source for game updates and on-site championship coverage via Twitter at Big South Game Day. Follow, watch, like, and share with the Big South Conference.
Good low. Swings it left side. White, 13 seconds shown on the shot clock. Gainey turns the corner, gets to the basket, shot no good.
Beautiful.
Might have been blocked by Garvin.
Beautiful help defense by Garvin just now.
Next dead ball will take it to the media timeout. Pass intended for Dickens. Deflected out of bounds, but a foul called on the Spartans, and that will take us to the media timeout. Pirates.
Sports.com. Stay for the best in Big South coverage, visit BigSouthSports.com. Stay current with the latest news, results, stats, standings, and much more. Enjoy video features showcasing remarkable student athletes or connect to school sites or social media outlets all from one place. Remember, the source for all your conference information is BigSouthSports.com.
Good move there by Garvin. But Dickens able to clean it up. Pushes the lead back to 10. Matches the largest lead of the game for Hampton. White in the lane. Drops it off.
I like how he used the rim to avoid the defender. That length of Dickens was unable to magically go through the rim.
Wise play there for the Spartans. Haskett looks inside for DeJour. DeJour rushed that one a little bit. Jumper back iron, no good. Transition opportunity. Goodlow to the cup. Shot is blocked.
Ooh.
And we're trying to.
And they're going to call that a hip check on number 5.
I don't know. We can take another look at it here.
That was
got a good
clean
angle.
Nah,
ooh,
that was
nah
clean.
Nah, that's
man
clean. He missed that one.
Refs are human. Refs are allowed to make mistakes, but that right there, that's a big mistake.
First free throw, good. Second free throw, no good. First miss, if my memory is correct.
Yes, yes. 11 of 12 on the evening for the Spartans from the charity stripe. No longer perfect.
Dean finds Haskett. Drop off, long jumper. DeJour front iron, no good. Ball is knocked out of bounds. They'll say last touch by the Pirates.
Haskett was trying to do his best in tapping the ball back, but he didn't have anybody to tap the ball to. So out of bounds, ball goes to Spartans.
Man-to-man defensive look from the Pirates this possession. Dribble drive. It's Ganey receiving it in the corner. Two-man game. Three is up, and it's
knocks
good.
It down.
Monzone came open for just long enough to knock down the three.
I believe the saying goes, hand down, man down.
Turnover. Ganey drives. Layup no good. Foul will be charged to, I believe, Garvin.
I want to say that's the first turnover that we've seen from the Pirates in this half. So far, a clean game on both sides. A clean second half, I should say, by both sides. And Garvin just unable to avoid that contact and draws the foul. And sends Ganey to the line. And he knocks down his first.
12 of 13 are the Spartans from the free throw line.
Quietly creeping back into this game. Knocks them both down. So what was once a 10-point lead
has very quickly dwindled down to two.
Wow.
Dean swings left side, Garvin. Good help from Goodlow. Garvin never saw the double coming. And the layup is good, and we got a tie ball game at 51. 10-0 run brings this to an all tied, brings us all tied up.
Yeah. An
18-11 run here in this second half.
That's a wise timeout right there. You just want to try to stop the momentum. Brazil doing a great job of getting into the paint and controlling his body. So we'll be back right now. Taking a look here at Deuce Dean.
Nearly converting another three-point play.
That has been his bread and butter for the evening. Dribble drive, layup. Doesn't matter if he finishes with his left or his right. He is looking for that contact.
Free throw is good. Ends what was a 10-0 run for the Spartans.
Coach Joyner just looking for a way to stop the hemorrhaging at the moment. Timeouts to do that. Sometimes, you know, you just got to talk to your troops and
circle the wagons.
Yeah, circle the wagons and get back up.
And they're up two. We're showing full court pressure now. Spartans, Goodlow will just walk the ball at the middle of the floor. 22 seconds showing on the shot clock. Man-to-man defensive front for the Pirates. Goodlow, free throw line jumper, front iron, no good. Pirates secure the rebound and look to add to what is a two-point advantage.
Right now, Buck has his bigs on the floor.
Epps couldn't save it. Comes back to the Spartans.
That was good hustle by Ganey.
Yeah, typically they say never save it under the other team's basket, but he was able to come away with it. And again, you see just the presence of DeJour Dickens and Godwin. Just, I don't know what happened. Looked like he had an opportunity to lay up and just lost his balance.
Yeah, I think he thought the defender was a little closer than they actually were, and he kind of hesitated, which took away that opportunity.
Gainey drives, and they're going to get an offensive foul on Gainey for a push-off or a hook, and that takes us to the media timeout. You're watching ESPN Plus. We'll be back. Visit HerculesTires.com. Ingles, low prices, love the savings. Sunbelt Rentals, we have equipment for that. And First Citizens Bank, forever first. We resume action. Pirates with the ball, leading by two. 11:40 remaining in the ball game. Pirates led by as many as 10 before the Spartans were able to tie it up. And Garvin going to look to extend this lead. Spinning from the double, floater is good.
And that's where you want to see Najee Garvin in the paint doing work.
Patient, read the defense, made his move, and is able to convert. As Spartans right now offensively look to be out of sorts.
And Brazil's just looking around trying to figure out, coach, what am I supposed to be doing right now?
12 seconds on the shot clock. Goodlow going to try and create. And we're going to have a foul on the floor. They're going to call it on the floor. It's going to be Epps called for the personal. And that's going to be his fourth. D'Angelo Epps with the tough assignment today of having to guard Monzone. Be a baseline inbound here for the Spartans. Goodlow throws it in deep to White. White steps into an open three. Front iron, no good. Rebound to Dickens. Dean in the lane. Floater, good. Nice touch around the basket for Deuce Dean. And just like that, the Pirates lead is back to six. Man-to-man look. Monzone, three with a hand in his face. And that young man is just feeling it right now. That's his third made three-point bucket. 17 points. Let's make that 20. 20 of the Spartans, 54 coming from Monzone. Entry pass down low. Dickens couldn't get the jumper to fall, and he's going to be called for over the back, trying to chase down his miss. It'll be his third. Team seventh. One and one opportunity here. Bryson Monzone at the free throw line. He's been perfect today. 5 of 5, now make him 6 for 6.
We can tell who practices free throw shooting.
So far, only one miss today for the Spartans, and that came from Goodlow, who's still 3 for 4. They're both good. Pirates led by as many as 6 here recently. Now it's down to 1. But they dribble handoff. Dean throws it. And a foul as Deuce, trusting his center, put that ball on a rope. And Dejor Dickens was fouled by Goodlow. Three free throw, no good. So we inch closer and closer here to the end of the second half. Those free throws are so very crucial, especially when a team like Upstate, the number two free throw shooting program in the conference right now, are almost automatic.
Yeah, man, they've been able to stay in this game because of their free throws.
Entry pass down low. Monzon shot blocked. Good effort by Dickens on the help side, but to your point, Joe, Spartans 15 of 16 from the free throw line, Pirates 13 of 17. Normally 13 of 17, you chalked it up as a good night, but when your opponents only miss one.
Yeah. You got to try to match what your opponent is doing at all times, as long as it's in the right category.
Monzon will put on the floor. Backing down, but they a fadeaway jumper. Got the front iron in the roll. Monzon right now is just putting the team on his back. Have tied the game here at 58. Dean in the lane. Shot is up, no good, but a foul will be called against the Spartans.
I mean, if it's working, I wouldn't go away from it. And Deuce Dean is not going away from his game right now.
Foul looks to be against Brazil.
Although Upstate has come back into this game to tie it up, the Pirates have definitely had their opportunities. Like you said earlier, it's all about free throws, and the Pirates just haven't been able to match the free throw intensity of the Spartans.
The intensity, the frequency, the overall execution, whatever word you want to use, my friend, you are right.
They have had more opportunities.
Dean knocks down both, and the seesaw battle continues. Pirates back on top by two. Brazil looking down low. Shot up and good. That was Smith able to avoid the shot block attempt from Dickens.
Almost just did not count at all for Dickens, as Dean almost throws it away, gets it to Garvin, but he'll be charged with the offensive foul. Wow. That was just one of those sequence of events that only the basketball gods can explain.
That's important. Believe that was the fourth on Garvin.
He's visibly upset. He's kind of arguing with the ref right now. He has to be careful before he gets teed up and then has a seat for the rest of the evening. Right now it's just about playing smart basketball.
Monzon goes baseline. Shot no good, affected by Dejor Dickens' presence. Again, doesn't show up in the stat sheet, Joe, but a very crucial play there for Dejor Dickens, as Epps will return to the floor and he'll replace Garvin, who right now, as you said before, one foul away from having the best seat in the house here in the Convocation Center.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Haskett. Brazil able to get a hand in there. Dean trying to create some movement. Offensively, entry pass goes to Dickens. He loses it. Fast break opportunity. Good transition D.
Ooh, that was a close travel.
Yeah, Smith almost gave it away. Good low. Open three. Good.
Knocks it down and puts the Spartans up three with just 8 minutes left in this game.
So far, Upstate outscoring the Pirates by 10, 30 to 20 here in the second half. Dean backing down Brazil. Layup up, no good, but it's stuffed home by Dejor Dickens.
I think we have an official timeout.
Yeah, Brazil went down, and there were some words being exchanged between Brazil and some of his teammates and the official.
I think he's happy about his back being climbed. I mean, it was a taller 7-footer over him.
And we've got the media timeout, so we'll take a break here. Spartans lead by one. You're watching ESPN Plus. Tires right on our strength. I mean, we could have picked one of the, three putbacks he's had. One was a dunk, and two, he was just able to get the putback to go. So it's a one-point ball game. A lot of ball left to be played here. 7.5 to go, Jeff.
Absolutely. Pirates are going to have to lock down on defense. They've let the Spartans climb back into this, and, I mean, that is actually really good offense by the Spartans as well, just capitalizing on the opportunities afforded to them by the Pirates.
And another foul call, this time on Ray Bethea. And again, free throws so crucial here, especially Monzon, who tonight has not missed. Team has only missed one total. So.
And as we often hear,
he is human.
You jinxed it. But as we often hear here at the Convocation Center, free throws win the ball game, and USC Upstate has adopted that mantra this evening, having gone 15 of 17. Scratch that, 16 of 18 from the line.
The lead is at 2. So, again, only 2 missed free throws tonight for the Spartans. So, as we continue to get closer to the end of this game, those free throws will be so very crucial. Deuce Dean, shot blocked.
Wow.
Tried to soar over Brizel. Brizel's athleticism able to meet him and get the block, and more importantly, control the loose ball.
Yeah, when they say somebody has bunnies, they're talking about Brizel.
Monzon looks right, white. 12 seconds on the shot clock. Monzon going to have to put it on the floor. Pull-up jumper off the mark. Rebound controlled by the Pirates.
Right now with the guards on the floor for Coach Joyner, they're going to be looking to push the pace, I believe.
Luke Darien on the floor. Getting his first action here in the second half. Ray Bethea trying to find some room to operate. 8 seconds, Deuce Dean. Going to have to create, looking for a screen. Steps back, and he's going to draw the foul. With 3 seconds on the shot clock, Rizel is called for the reach.
That was a
– to me, it was a good call.
It was a great call. That was a great call. I mean, anybody could see that Rizel grabbed Deuce's arm. Deuce, he was thinking about shooting the three. Now I'm thinking he wish he would have shot the three. He'd be headed to the line for three.
Yep. Both teams now with 9 team fouls and still with 6 minutes to play. The next foul on either team will be an automatic 2 for the rest of the game. Dean cannot get the free throw to fall. So Spartans lead stays at 2. White will call out the set. Aldridge dribble drive. Looking for Goodlow. Now Monzon. 13 seconds on the shot clock. White, long three, and
wow.
It's good.
He's got range.
They dared him to take it. Dean was looking to play under the screen, and White makes it a 2-possession ball game in favor of USC Upstate.
Range like Ainge. Wow.
Epps goes right. Haskett in the lane, loses it. Under control, Epps pull-up jumper is good.
And that's what I want to see more from D'Angelo. Insert yourself offensively into the game. We know you are great on the defensive end, but get into this thing and put some points on the board.
Nearing the 5-minute mark. Aldridge driving. It's going to be a blocking
foul.
Wow,
that's a tough call.
Yeah, those can go either way. Unfortunately, if you're a Pirate fan, it is the 10th team foul. And Aldridge will head to the free throw line for the first time today, I believe.
Haskett can't believe it. He's like, I was set. I was down there. I was set. You see the size difference. I couldn't move, and I ended up on the ground. How does that happen? Well, the ref said
Aldridge,
your feet were moving.
A 92 42% free throw shooter.
So automatic is what you're saying.
Highly probable. And it's good. Dickens will return to the floor. One more on the way here for Aldridge. Can push it back to a 5-point advantage for the Spartans. And it's good.
'69-64 with 5:05 left in this game.
Haskett thought about the long shot.
He did not take it.
Floater short. Wow, they call a foul on Dickens as Goodlow looks like he lost his balance and fell into DeJour. And that's his fourth.
Wow. That's a tough call for the Pirates.
Godwin going to head to the scores table. And this parade to the free throw line, not what you want if you're a Pirate fan, but at least Goodlow is listed here as a 68% free throw shooter, but that one looked pretty clean to me.
Yeah. He's been able to convert on his last few trips to the line here. So
both free throws good.
Right now, if you're the Pirates, you see Marquise Godwin come back into the game. You're looking for some instant offense. His favorite place to shoot from is in the corner. So I won't be surprised if we see him get to the corner or close to it and start launching threes.
Time starting to become an enemy for the Pirates. Haskett in the lane, drives to the cup, layup is good, but we're waiting for the call, and they're going to say the defender was in the restricted zone. So it will be a 3-point opportunity here for Mario Haskett.
And I want to see more of that from Haskett as we go down the stretch of this game. Don't settle for the jump shots. Don't settle for the 3-point opportunities. Dribble drive like this, get into the paint, and create contact.
Haskett shooting the and one, and it's good. It's a 4-point ball game. The Pirates trying to find some offense.
They say good
Aldridge
defense.
Will spot up for three, no good. Rebound goes out of bounds, and it will be last touch by Haskett.
You know what they say, good defense leads to better offense, and right now the Pirates are going to have to play some of the best defense that they can possibly muster up. Meanwhile, Spartans, they're going to have a couple balls bounce their way.
Yeah, they're trying to execute here. They've got a fresh 20 on the reset. They're going to screen to try and get the ball into Aldridge. White with 15 seconds. The drive, short, rebound controlled by Haskett. Good defense there for Hampton.
Hear the player saying the ball is wet. He's got one thought about it. Kicks back out to Dean. 8 seconds on the clock. Dean trying to create something. Looking for a wide open DeJour, and he just can't hold on to the pass. That was a wide open dunk waiting for the big man.
There were two players wide open. Not only was DeJour open in the middle of the paint, I believe it was Godwin was wide open at the top of the key. So,
wow,
what a missed opportunity for Hampton. Two good looks at the basket result in a turnover, as right now the Spartans are in no rush. An air ball there as Monzon had to put up a shot. And that'll take us to the media timeout. Spartans lead by
to ESPN Plus, Big South Basketball. Take a look at some of these stats here.
The hustle stats.
Hustle stats. The Pirates are dominating right now, almost double the points in the paint. However, they are down in this contest four with just under 2 minutes remaining.
And there you, there's your double right there. Deuce Dean, nice backdoor cut, nice set out of the timeout. And the Pirates trail by two.
And Dean has been carrying this Pirates team the entire game. Some pivotal buckets.
Garvin doing a good job of playing defense without fouling. The awkward bounce off the rim just out of their reach of Dejor Dickens. Lead goes back to four. So we near the 2 minute mark. Haskett in the lane, throws it out wide to Epps, who nearly loses it. Epps into contact. Back to Dean, 6 seconds. Dean gonna have to create. Step back, his three. Front iron, no good.
And that just seemed like a busted possession for the Pirates. They cannot, I repeat, they cannot have any more of those moving down the stretch.
1:44 remaining.
You saw Dalvin White just go ahead and launch a three. You saw that go in, so he may be feeling that confident where he's going to start launching threes as this thing winds down, Matt.
Looking ahead on Saturday, the Pirates will play host to Winthrop. That game set for 5:30 p.m. tip-off. We'll have it right here on ESPN Plus. And looking ahead for the Spartans on their schedule, their next game. Coming up here shortly. Their next game will be also on Saturday as they will be back home playing host to the Campbell Camels. Tip off there at 4 p.m. Game also will be brought to you live right here on ESPN Plus.
Say that five times in a row. Campbell Camels.
I respectfully decline. 98 seconds. Spartans lead by four. Nearly turned it over. Gainey goes to the floor, and somehow the ball finds the teammate, and they hit the bucket. Good low. Right place, right time.
Right place, right time, and Dejor is lucky the refs didn't call a foul on that.
So it's a six-point ball game, two possession if you go by 3 point shots. You're going to need to get a quick shot here, and somehow, some way, that ball found its way to Goodlow, and he calmly, with the high arcing shot over the outstretched arms of Dickens, knocks it down.
Goodlow's been knocking down some pretty big shots. Hampton with the overall percentage of 45.5% from the field. USC Upstate shooting 40%, but the separation is 90.5% from the free throw line versus 77.3%. Matt, if you ever shoot 90%, it's almost guaranteed you might win that game.
Quick look around the scoreboard, the Sunbelt Rentals out-of-town scoreboard final. Gardner-Webb 65-57 over High Point. Longwood 56-48 over Asheville. And Radford 64-52 over Charleston Southern as Deuce Dean lost control of the ball. Somehow Pirates got it back. It's still loose. And it will be a foul, I believe, on Epps. And I believe that will be his fifth.
Fifth, and he'll enjoy the rest of this game from what did you call it, the best seat in Convocation Center?
Unfortunately, that will be the case for Mr. Epps. Don't know what happened. It just looked to be that last play was just never seemed to really get going for the Pirates as Godwin will look to check in and replace Epps.
It's quick hands by the Spartans on that possession. Epps was trying to get the ball back out, and he just put a body on White,
who's now at the free throw line. And to finish that out-of-town scoreboard with 42 seconds left. Presbyterian leading Campbell 61-55. White with two shots. Trying to put this one away for his Spartans, and the first one is good.
So a six-point lead.
White becomes the fourth Spartan to enter double figures with 10. This free throw gives him 11.
So an eight-point lead right now for the Spartans. The Pirates have their work cut out for them.
Dean down the lane, layup is good. Pirates down six, need to create turnovers and do it quickly. And unfortunately, this is the worst team to have to foul in these scenarios.
Yeah, you don't want to go to the hack-a-shack method against the Spartans.
And from at least the players that we've seen on the floor, the player with the worst free throw percentage isn't even on the floor right now. That was Goodlow. And it looks like he might check back in, but Gainey, free throw, no good.
Wow.
Not a time to start missing free throws for the Spartans.
You know, sometimes your nerves just get the best of you a little bit, but he'll settle down.
If you're Hampton, you got to be prepared for the mix and box out. Goodlow offers the defense here with Aldridge. Oh, no, check that. He's going to replace Smith. Spartans will fall back into the half-court set. Leading by seven, Pirates will roll it to midcourt. Dean, again, to the cup. He's fouled. Couldn't get the layup to fall, though.
And as the leader of the team, this is what Dean should be doing. He should be trying to penetrate this defense and get to the bucket. Put some points on the board. Your team is down by seven right now, and the time is not in your favor. Taking his time trying to make sure he is set. Knocks down that first opportunity.
It's down to six again. Arvin. Offense to defense.
Second shot up and good. So back to a five-point advantage.
And White left wide open, and he will be fouled again. At this point, its game is becoming a free throw shooting contest that unfortunately is not leaning in the favor of the Pirates
not
if you are rooting for Hampton.
Not at
but the
all.
Fans of the Spartans are liking the way this one is unfolding as their team 22 of 25 from the free throw line, 88%. Give them another one.
And right now, the Spartans are loving how this is
this game is
up.
This game is pretty even except for one area, the Spartans 7 of 19 from 3. Hampton just 3 of 13 as White makes both free throws. This time Gainey forcing the Pirates to pick the ball up deeper in the backcourt. Haskett going to pull the three. Shot is up. It is good.
And that is what you need. That is what they needed. That's what Haskett has been trying to do all game. Knock down some open threes.
Makes it a four-point ball game, so we'll keep it right here. Again, a reminder, Hampton will be back home on Saturday, 5:30 matchup with the Winthrop Eagles. USC Upstate will be back home on Saturday. They'll be playing host to the Campbell Camels. Game is set for a 4 p.m. tip-off. And one last reminder, join us in the Queen City, Joe. Big South basketball fans, six exciting days in March. We'll see us go from 24 men's and women's teams at the start to two champions at the finish. All in one venue, it's the 2022 Hercules Tires Big South Basketball Championship at Charlotte's Bojangles Coliseum. Tickets and event information can be found now at BigSouthSports.com/CLTChamps. Make plans to come support your team in Charlotte March 1st through the 6th.
The Queen City, I miss it.
I do too, my friend. And one last announcement. That three by Mario Haskett, we're going to go ahead and say that's what fans like. Make sure you pick up an ice cold, refreshing Pepsi today. That's what I like. Big three-point shot there. Gives the Pirates. It keeps the door open just a sliver.
Just a sliver.
Pirates going to try and get the trap here and then the foul.
That's going to be on Bidet.
That's his third personal, and it will send Ganey back to the free throw line, who just on his last trip split the pair.
And if you are a Pirates fan,
you're hoping that history repeats itself.
Exactly.
Or worse, he misses both.
He misses
but
both.
We know that's not going to happen. This team is too well coached. They are very strong from the free throw line. Again, the number two free throw shooting team in the Big South as Ganey knocked down the first.
6.7 seconds left to go in this one. Pirates really do have their work cut out for them on the offensive end.
Second shot on the way from the freshman by way of Tucson, Arizona. That one took a bounce but still will fall.
Pirates looking for the quick strike on this possession.
And they're going to call a foul as Dean tried to lob it up to Dickens, and they're going to call Aldridge for a hold as Dickens went up for the tip, and it will be two free throws here for Dejor Dickens.
And that possession for it to materialize, it just took a little too long for my likings. I mean, it's almost 10 seconds off the clock. You need, what, a whole nother possession, two possessions?
That and I hope they don't. Free throw is good. I was going to say, you hope with all that, you know, possessions you're counting, also that the Spartans don't score.
He's able to knock down his first. Second shot. Up. Good. So, four point advantage for the Spartans right now.
Pirates are looking for a quick turnover, but have to foul. And I believe it will be Ganey again.
It'll be four on Bethea.
Four on number four. I think those are some numbers you should play on
2-2-22.
2-2-22. Four on four.
Wait till 2-22-22.
Ganey, free throw up. It's good. Big moments here for this young man just at the beginning of his career here with the Spartans, and here knocking down clutch free throws here trying to stave off this hungry Pirate team trying to claw their way back into it here in these waning seconds.
And the fans are making noise, but it doesn't bother him not one bit.
Dean uses a screen. A lot of time. Godwin, two defenders waiting on him. He'll pull. Shot, front iron, no good. Rebound and a quick foul with 15 seconds.
Darvin's going to have a seat for the rest of this game. And that he couldn't avoid it. Trying to stop the clock. Give their team an opportunity to at least do something short of a miracle.
Leading scorer for the game is at the free throw line. His first free throw was no good.
Wow, a rare miss from the Spartans. A rare miss from Monzone.
24 points for him. 7 of 14 shooting from the floor. 3 of 7 from 3. 7 of 9 now from the free throw line. And with 15 seconds left, Pirates need a few miracles here. Haskett, another catch and shoot three, no good. Rebound to Monzone, and I believe the Pirates will not foul. They will let the last 3 seconds tick away here as the Spartans come away with a tough road victory by the final 85-78. Monzone, your leading scorer with 25. Gainey with 18. White with 13. Goodlow with 12. And for the Pirates, Deuce Dean leads away with 24. Najee Garvin with 15. Dickens with 17. Any final thoughts, Joe, as we go into our post-game wrap-up?
It was a pretty even matchup throughout the entire game. What killed the Pirates in this one was the great free-throw shooting by the Spartans. I mean, they came into this thing, and they just killed it from the free-throw line, going 29 of 33, and the Pirates just weren't able to capitalize on big possessions late in the game. So
that will do it for our Hercules Tires game summary. From our broadcast partner, Joseph Walters, our crew here at the Hampton Convocation Center. Good night here on ESPN+. We'll see you on Saturday.